If you're already a subscriber, welcome back. And if you're here for the first time, do subscribe to the channel and do press the bell icon on the YouTube app, and you will never miss any new videos that we release.
So these three are different right now, as you can see. This one is the shortest between point A to point B, start to finish. This one goes down first and then goes forward like this. And this one goes horizontal almost, slowly starts increasing the speed and then keeps increasing it. So the thing is that one would normally imagine that the shortest one, this will go the fastest, but no. So this one goes down very fast and uses the same momentum to reach the end. So this goes the fastest. And in fact, this one goes the slowest because when others are racing downwards, this one is going gently down the slope, slowly walking, slowly increasing speed, and then it increases the speed. By then, the other two are already finished. So this is quite interesting because this is what you would imagine as the fastest, but this is the fastest. And this follows some other principles, which I'll explain in the science behind. So why I've used these pipes is because everywhere I saw the experiment, it was a rigid wooden framework or some kind of a channel, which was rigid. I wanted to make something flexible so that you can show this experiment even by using only one pipe. And now using only one track, we can show this path. We can just twist the pipe and shorten the distance. And then you can show a more or less straight path. And then you can make it down and show the fastest curve. So this is why we use this thing, which makes it quite interesting because now you can use different kind of curves and all you have to do is take a slow motion camera and time it from start point to the end point. And you can do many experiments like this.